Good day, and welcome to another episode of the Albino Rhino Booze Review. Today we'll be doing Grants Blended Scotch. Now, first off, if I'm buying scotch, I like single malt better than blended. There's nothing really wrong with a blended scotch. I just would rather buy a scotch where every scotch in the batch is the exact same. I don't like cognac for the same reason I don't really like blended scotch. Because, really, it aren't guaranteed to get the same taste all the time because what they're doing is mixing a whole bunch of batches together. Now, Grants is distilled by the William Grant & Sons Distillery in Scotland. If you read a history about Grants and Innocent Gun, Grants is the company that commissioned them to make their barrels filled with beer so that they could make a beer-flavored scotch. I don't think that would have been good, but a scotch-flavored beer worked out well. Anyway, this is a 1.14-liter bottle. I believe it was $36, the cheapest thing you could ever find at 1.14 liters. This is my mooch scotch. Not because it's really bad, I could find worse scotches out there than this thing, but at that price, this is what I give people that don't bring. Scent-wise, you get a lot of the alcohol. You get some vanilla, you get some oak, you get some toffee, you get a tiny bit of caramel, and there's a tiny bit of peat moss. I haven't looked up where this city is in Scotland, so I don't know if they're from the island of Islay or not, but it has a tiny smoky characteristic to it. What's this stuff taste like? Well, for a cheap scotch, it doesn't really have the burn you would expect it to. I mean, I'm not saying it doesn't burn, because it does, but it doesn't have that mouth on fire burn that you'd expect from cheap stuff. So it's well made. The vanilla comes out, the oak comes out, there's a bit of cedar in there, there's a bit of toffee, there's a bit of caramel. It actually mixes fairly well. The alcohol burn does come up the back of your throat afterwards, but you don't really get an alcohol taste on it. On the rocks, this would probably be fairly good. Fairly cheap for the bottle size that it is. Really, there's nothing wrong with Grants. Even though you might think I feel that way because of the fact that it's my mooch scotch. But it's my mooch scotch just because of the price. Really, I would probably put this at a 5.5 out of 10. There's nothing wrong with it. It's just not very good. It's not as flavorful as the scotches that I would rather drink. So thank you for watching the Albino Rhino Beer Review. Wow, I must be getting drunk. Thank you for watching the Albino Rhino Booze Review. Good booze drinking to yous. Have a good night. Bye.